Hi, I'm Patu from Freepin Cal. Today, let's talk about multi-asset mutual funds and if it makes sense to invest in them and when to invest in such funds. So, a multi-asset mutual fund is a new category that was sort of introduced by SEBI. I don't know why they did it, but they did it when they did the whole rejig of all the categories and so on. So all multi-asset mutual funds came into existence only from the mid of 2018. And in this, I have not taken into account Quantum's multi-asset fund of fund, but that's technically a fund of funds, so I've not taken that into account. So these, I'm only talking about funds that directly invest in these multi-assets. And of course, a part of it can be in other ETFs and so on. So a multi-asset mutual fund is something that must invest 10% of its assets in three asset classes. And those three asset classes are equity, bonds, that is debt, and gold. Commodities can also, in general, the 10% can be commodities, because now you have a lot more commodities added in other than gold. I forgot the full list, but silver can be part of them. So I talked about the gold versus silver video, and this I mentioned that up to 30% the commodities, other commodities can be accommodated in the portfolio. Gold doesn't have that limit. Other than gold, other commodities, up to 30% can be part of a multi-asset portfolio. Now, this is a big problem, because it's only 10% is defined. The mutual funds can do whatever they want with the rest of the the rest of the portfolio. See, they can just hold 10% equity, 10% bonds, 10% gold. That's the requirement. The rest is 70% of the portfolio. They can pretty much play with any which way they want. That means you will get all sorts of funds in the same category. This is the whole point of saying X is one category, means all the funds should behave in the same way. But that's completely lost when you have such a very timid requirement to comply with. So other than that, of course, SEBI has also mandated that international equity is not a separate asset class. It has to be part of the equity asset class. I talked about this in the Motilal Oswal multi-asset fund. So that's that. And there are something like 9 existing funds, and to this 9, that is before the category rejig, these funds existed and they kind of transformed into multi-asset funds. So in addition to these 9, we have 3 new funds: the Motilal Oswal, which I just said, Tata multi-asset, and Nippon India multi-asset. These are new funds, just few months. Nippon is not yet, just finished its NFO period. The others of Tata is few months old. Motilal is just about listed or about to list, whatever it is. So in these, we have debt-oriented funds like Nippon, Motilal, and so far SBI. So Nippon and Motilal, they allow only 50% equity. They have said that they are going to have only 50% equity. That means, by law, by income tax laws, they have debt oriented mutual funds, or technically non equity mutual funds, I should say. SBI, so far, as we shall see, so far it has held less than 65% equity, but it can hold much more than that. And we have proper equity oriented mutual funds from ICICI, HDFC, Axis, and so on. And like I just said, along with SBI, there is also Quant Mutual Fund, which can vary its equity allocation from less than 65% to more than 65%, and so on. So all sorts of variations are possible. And because of so much variations, star rating so far does not make any sense. Of course, so far they have not given star ratings, because they have to comply with the 3-year rule. As a new fund, they don't have the history to provide the star rating. But even if they do provide star ratings, you understand that you are comparing apples with tomatoes, because both of them are red. So that kind of comparison is meaningless, and you should not use this unless you are clear what the fund mandate is and you know why you are investing and what is your objective. If you don't do it, of course, that is true for any fund, but particularly for multi-asset funds, because many people kind of tend to think, oh, it's multi-assets, I can treat it as a single fund portfolio. I mean, I can just invest one in that fund and so on. Don't do that kind of things. It can be very risky because we don't really know much about these funds. It's very, very important to understand. So in this graph, I have plotted the monthly equity allocation weights of these multi-asset funds. The red is this SBI fund. The SBI fund can, it can actually, you know, go, its equity can go up to 80% in the according to the scheme document, but it has only varied from about 12% to maximum 50% or so, although it can go up to 80%. So far it has been a debt oriented fund from about May 2018 onwards. This black line is the quant fund, which has varied equity allocation rapidly. So one question is taxation. What kind of taxation? When you exit the fund, you have to look at the tax status as per the, the AMC will release the tax status, then you have to use that and pay tax accordingly. So don't get into that kind of business, it's painful. Then you can see most of the other funds have maintained more or less 65% or above kind of equity allocation. So that's, in that sense, it's good. Now for long-term goals, this, if you want to use a multi-asset fund, first of all, don't expect it to be significantly less volatile than a diversified equity fund. I have shown the standard deviation for the last 1 and 2 years for ICICI, the ICICI fund family. You can see this is ICICI aggressive hybrid, multi-asset, balanced advantage, blue chip. Just to give you an example of a diversified fund. You can see the standard deviation for the last 1 year and 2 years. There's not much of a difference. Multi-asset is just a little bit less volatile than a diversified equity fund. Other than that, you should not expect too much. Therefore, for long-term goals, multi-asset should be, if you are going to use multi-asset, use it as the core portfolio holding. Most of the weight should be in the multi-asset fund. Otherwise, it makes no sense. The other assets will have very little impact in your portfolio. Second, the equity mandate should be very narrow. For long-term goals, you can have 10 years and above, you can have 65 to 80% equity mandate. That's a good mandate. It is almost like buying an aggressive hybrid fund. ICICI, HDFC, Axis, those three AMCs have this kind of mandate. The problem is, you can argue, why should I use multi-asset if I already have aggressive hybrid? That argument, I cannot defend multi-asset funds from that point of view, because so far we have no data. And that's a very good argument. And I would say, go ahead and use aggressive hybrid instead of multi-asset. So this is the problem. So when you are going to reduce equity below 65%, let us say you hold 50% equity only, the fund holds 50% equity only, then the volatility reduction will be significant. The multi-asset benefit will be probably better, but the tax status will hit. And if you are going to invest for long-term goals, your returns may be lower. So that balance is a problem all the time. And that's going to be a problem. My suggestion is, for long term, you can use either multi-asset, this kind of 65 to 80% equity kind of multi-assets, or aggressive hybrid. For short term, medium term, avoid multi-asset funds. Don't bother with it. Some AMCs are saying 3 years and above. HDFC, I think, says 3 years and above you can use multi-asset. That is wrong. Please treat at least HDFC's own multi-asset fund should be treated as a proper equity fund, pure equity fund only. So be careful with these kind of wordings and suggestions. Other than that, my own situation, I think I have talked about this sometime back. I hold ICICI multi-asset. About 1/3 of my son's equity portfolio is in ICICI multi-asset. The reason for that is, I was holding for a while now, I think 2011 onwards, I've been holding ICICI Dynamic. That fund became multi-asset, so I just continued holding it. I knew that for that kind of AUM, 10,000 plus crores, they will not suddenly make it a non-equity fund in terms of tax status. So I decided to just hold on to it and see what happens. I have not found any big difference in the returns between the old situation and now. It has more or less been the same. I don't see any big perceivable change in my portfolio. I have not seen. Other than that, the fund has been going on well. Dynamic was a good fund. Multi-asset has continued that behavior, except that it has got two additional components of 10% equity and 10% gold and minimum 10% gold and minimum 10% bonds. So that's what I got to say. I'll catch you later. Bye-bye.